See, we are in the general ledger accounting. Last week, we have seen how to park the documents. Yes. So today we have to see hold documents. So first let us try to understand the concept of hold documents. Right? Let me close all other files. One second. Okay. One second. See, holding documents. It is the activity of keeping the documents pending for posting due to want of information. Here, in order to post one document, we need to have minimum two line items, right? One should be the debit line item and the other should be the credit line item. Sometimes what happens is some information regarding some of the line items may be missing. So in that case, the user enters the document into system with the information available. Then he will keep it pending for posting. That is called hold document. After some time, the required information may be available. So when the required information is available, we can retrieve the held document from the database. We can provide the missing information, then we can post it. Then only the GL accounts are updated. So these hold documents are also called incomplete document. Here, the difference between parking documents and hold documents is, if the document is kept pending for posting due to want of authorization, that is called park document. If the document is kept pending for posting because of want of information, then that is called hold document. So the hold documents are temporary documents or they are the incomplete document. And at the time of holding the document, the user himself has to give the number because system cannot use the number ranges of SA type because the number ranges for SA type is for the completed documents. But here, hold document means it is incomplete document. That is why system cannot take the number from the SA type number ranges. So the user himself has to enter the number. That is called temporary document number. And the temporary document number can contain up to 10 characters and it is alphanumeric. Here, when you are holding the document, it will not update any GL accounts because that document is not posted. It is just kept pending for posting. That is the reason why the hold documents do not update any GL accounts. But when we complete the whole document and post it, then only the GL accounts are updated. For example, we are paying weekly wages. Let us assume today is Friday. So wages have been paid. So we know that wages account is to be debited. One second. Yes, sorry for the interruption. See, for example, we are paying weekly wages and today is the Friday. So we have paid wages. You know that wages account is to be debited, but the user does not have the information of mode of payment of wages. Means he does not know whether the wages have been paid in cash or the wages have been paid through check. If the wages is paid in cash, cash account is to be created. If the wages are transferred to the bank accounts of the workers, then bank account is to be created. Here, the user does not have that information. That's why we enter this transaction, debiting wages account. Then we keep it pending for posting. This is called hold document. After some time, you came to know that the wages have been paid in cash. Then you retrieve the HALDI document from the database, you supply the missing information and you will post it. Then only the GL accounts are updated. Extremely sorry, one second. After some time, you came to know that the wages have been paid in cash. Then you retrieve the HALDI document, right? You supply the credit information and post it. Then only the wages account and cash accounts are updated. So this is the function of the HALDI documents. And the transaction code is same. You have to go to the transaction code F-02 only. Holding a document, F-02. Document date is 2/4/2016. Type is equal to SA. Company code 3699. Company code 3699. Posting date 2/4/2016. Period 4. Currency GST. posting key copy. Posting key copy. The account is wages account, 4,200,000. Click on enter. The amount is equal to 3,000. The amount is equal to 3,000. Business area 3699. Business area 3699. Text being wages paid. I hope everybody is writing in the material. Text being wages paid. So we don't have the information regarding credit line item. Now I want to keep it pending. Go to menu document, hold. Go to menu document, hold. Temporary document number is equal to, give some number, ABC 100. Temporary document number is equal to ABC 100. Click on hold. See, document ABC 100 was held. This is how we can keep it, we can keep any document pending for posting when the total information is not available. Okay. See the next step. Posting of held document. So let us assume that after some time we came to know that the wages have been paid through cash, right? Now you have to get back the held document from the database. You provide the credit line information, then post it. For that we can use the same transaction code F-02. Go to menu document, get the held document. Otherwise, we can use the direct transaction code FB11. You can write this transaction code here. Go to menu document, click on held document, right? Then you give the transaction code FB11. Transaction code FB11. Temporary document number is equal to ABC 100. Suppose if you have held multiple number of documents and we have used different numbers, in that case click on document list button. So when you click on document list button, the system will display the list of all the held documents. Here we have only one held document. In that case you can double click on the held document number. Okay, no? Otherwise, if you remember the number, you can directly enter the number. So temporary document number is equal to ABC 100. Suppose if you want to delete it, after entering the document number, you can click on delete. That will be deleted. If you want to edit, you can edit it. But here, I want to complete and post. So temporary document number is equal to ABC 100. Click on enter. See, this is the debit line item. Now, credit line item information I am providing. Posting key 50. The account is 2,100,000. The account is 2,100,000. Click on enter. The amount is asterisk. Business area 3699. Business area 3699. Text plus. Now click on save. See, document number 9 was posted in the company code 3699. So this is the accounting document. Now the system has taken the number from the number range of document type FCA. Now your wages account and cash account should have been updated. You can display the document. See, factory wages accounted are to cash. So this is the function of the held document. held document. Now, see the next topic. And one more thing. Look at the material. Note. After the held document topic, I have given one note. If error message held documents must be converted is displayed, follow this procedure. Here, this error message is displayed by the system when you are holding the documents for the first time in the server. When you are holding the documents first time in the server, then the system will display this error document. Sorry, the system will display this error message. In that case, you have to perform one activity, right? Here in our case, it did not display any error message because I have been using the server, the same server, since 1 year for the different batches, right? For the first batch, I have done this setting. So when you get this error message, go to the transaction code SC38. You have to perform this only when you get the error message. Otherwise, it is not necessary. Program is equal to RFTMPBLU. Means it is the name of the program which is executed to hold the documents within the software. That is the name of the program. Program is equal to RFTMPBLU. Click on execute. Click on execute. Select no termination for read error. Then click on execute. See, no conversion necessary. All held documents are correct. So you have to execute this transaction code only when you get the error message. Now, see the next topic. Sample documents, right? Please put heading in the notes. Special documents. Special documents. Or reference documents. Or templates. Templates. Or posting techniques. So these are the different names to the same type of documents. There are two types of documents. There are two types of, please write down, there are two types of special documents. There are two types of special documents. Number one, sample documents. Number two, recurring documents. Number two, recurring documents. Continue. Using the special documents, we can reduce the posting burden on the employees. We can reduce the posting burden on the employees. How? Let us see now. So because in the real-time situation, what happens is every user has to post large volumes of transactions every day. So in order to save the time, right, SAP has developed two concepts. That is, one is sample documents and the other one is recurring documents. So using these two types of documents, you can reduce the posting burden on the employees to the maximum. How? Let us see. So first I will explain the concept of the sample documents. See, this is the special type of document. This is used to post the business transactions which occur frequently every day. Using the sample document, we can reduce the posting burden on the users. The sample document is the template for the original accounting document. The sample document is the template for original accounting document. Means what? I will give an example. See here, there are some expenses which take place number of times in a day. Suppose, for example, sundry expenses or general expenses. Sundry expenses means all the expenses for which it's not necessary to maintain the separate GL accounts. For example, tea coffee expenses, snacks expenses, right? Auto rickshaw charges. Like that, these are the sum of the GL accounts for which you need not maintain any separate GL accounts. Okay. So whenever you incur these expenses, we debit these expenses to one GL account, sundry expenses. So these sundry expenses are incurred number of times in a day. So whenever these sundry expenses are incurred, you have to post them into system. So when you incur sundry expenses, what is the entry to be posted? Sundry expense account it has to cash. Okay. So for this purpose, what we do, you go to the transaction code F-02, right? Then in F-02, we enter the document date, document type, company code, currency, period, posting date. And first line item is to be debited is what? Sundry expenses. So posting key 40, account is sundry expense account. Then you click on enter. We enter the amount, business area and text. Secondly, for the credit line item, you have to enter the posting key 50, account, cash account number, you click on enter, and amount, business area, text again, you have to enter for the second line item. Like that, every time when the user has to post the sundry expenses, he has to enter this much information. But if you observe, when you have to post the sundry expenses, always sundry expense account is to be debited. So posting key same, 40, account to be debited is 4 lakh, sundry expense account is same, business area may be same, text may be same. Similarly, the account to be created is always cash account. So posting key 50, account, cash account number, you click on enter, then business area may be same, then again text will be same. Then what is the element that is different every time? Only the amount. Am I right? That's why what we do is we create one dummy document with some dummy amount in which you debit sundry expense account and you credit cash account. With some dummy amount, you create one document. That document is called sample document. So when you create this sample document, that is stored in the database. It will not update any GL accounts. So whenever the user has to post the sundry expenses payment, he will retrieve the sample document from the database. He will just change the amount and post it. That is how every time the user is escaped from the burden of entering posting key, account number, business area, text for every line item. That's how it reduces the burden on the employees. Technically speaking, we can use the sample document for any business transaction. There isn't any restriction. But if you create the sample document for those business transactions, which occur frequently every day, then you have the special advantage. For example, take salaries. For the salaries payment also, we can create the sample document. But how many number of times you pay salaries in a month? Only one or two times. In that case, do you have any special advantage? No. But if you want, you can create. Nothing will prevent you. But if you create the sample document for those business transactions which occur frequently every day, we have the special advantage. Okay, no? So, when the sample documents are created, they are just stored in the database. They do not update any GL accounts, remember. But when you post the actual business transactions, using the sample document as template or using the sample document as a reference, then only the GL accounts are updated. And we have to maintain a separate number range for the sample documents. Why so? Because these are not the regular accounting documents. That's why we have to maintain a separate number range for the sample documents. And the number range number for the sample documents is X2. Just similar to 01 is the number range number for SA type, right? So X2 is the number range number for the sample documents. And look at the screen. The following functions are available for the sample documents. Number one, display. Number two, change. Number three, delete. So let us see how to create the sample documents and how to use it for the purpose of regular posting and how to change it, how to delete, all these functions we will see. But this is the function of the sample document. I hope the concept is clear to everybody. Configuration is very simple. Don't worry about the configuration. We have to understand the concept first. See the material. First, we have to maintain the number ranges. Creation of number ranges for sample documents. Transaction code FBN1. Company code is equal to 3699. Company code is equal to 3699. Click on change intervals. Click on insert intervals. Number is equal to X2. Year is equal to 2016. Look at the screen, everybody, please. Here, for 01, SA type, right? We have defined the number ranges 1 to 1 lakh. And you see, NR status means number range status. Till now, in the number range status column, we have 9, right? Means, till now, in the general ledger, we have posted 9 documents. That is the importance of this field. Okay? So, 1 to 1 lakh we have used for SA type, right? Now, we have to use it 1 lakh 1. From number is equal to 1 lakh 1. To number is 2 lakhs. Means we can create 1 lakh number of sample documents, but we never create this many number of sample documents in the real time. Just like that, everywhere I maintain a range of 1 lakh for the uniformity purpose in our training class, nothing else. You can say 1 lakh 1 to 1 lakh 10 also, right? Then click on save. In your material, 1 second. In your material, click on insert button is there, right? You strike it off. It's not necessary. After entering the number range, click on save. And enter on the message. You know, whenever you get this message, you have to click on enter. Now, see the next step. Create general expense account, master record, number 4,350 under administration cost group. We have to maintain the sundry expense account or general expense account. You have to maintain the master record. You know how to create the GL account master record. Already we have seen that. That's why I did not give all the steps there. This general expense account I have taken as part of administration cost. So this account is to be created under the administration cost group. For the administration cost group, we have defined the number ranges 4,300 to 4,399. So I have taken 4,350, nothing else. You can take if you want 4,325 also. But the transaction code is not there. Please add the transaction code FSWG. GL account is equal to 4,350. GL account is equal to 4,350. Company code 3699. Go to menu GL account create. Account group is administration cost. Account group is administration cost. Select P&L statement account. Select P&L statement account. Short text is equal to general expenses account. Short text is equal to general expense account. GL account long text is also general expense account. Go to control data tab. Account currency USD. Select only balances in local currency. Select to line item display. Same procedure, no change at all. Sort key 001. Sort key 001. Go to create bank interest tab. Field status group G001. Click on save. Now, creation of sample document. Transaction code F-01. One second. Transaction code F-01. Enter sample document, right? Document date is 2/4/2016. Type is equal to SCA. Company code 3699. Posting date 2/4/2016. I hope everybody is writing in the material. Period is equal to 4. Currency USD. As usual, very similar. 2F-02. Posting key 40. Posting key 40. Account is 4,350. Account is 4,350. Click on enter. Amount is, say, $5. Business area 3699. Business area 3699. Text being sundry expenses paid, text being sundry expenses paid. Posting key 50. Posting key 50. Account is 2,100,000. Account is 2,100,000. Click on enter. Amount is $5. Business area 3699. Text being sundry expenses paid. Otherwise, you can enter plus also. Click on display document overview. See, general expense account data to cash. Click on save. See, look at the message carefully. Document 1,01,000 was stored in the company code 3699, not posted, remember. When you post that document in F-02, you have been receiving the message, so and so document was posted. Means your GL accounts are updated. But here, document 1,01,000 was stored in the company code. Means it was just stored in the database. It did not update any balances in the GL accounts. Then, from where the system has taken the document number 1,01,000? Just now, we have defined the number ranges. 1,01,000 to 2,00,000 for X2. X2 means sample document, right? So this is the first sample document we have created. That's why system has taken the document number 1,01,000. If you create the sample document for another business transaction, it will take 1,02,000. Like that, the user will be creating the sample documents like this. So the sample document does not update any GL accounts. How can you verify whether the sundry expense account is updated or not? If you go to FS10N, GL account balance display, you give the GL account number 4,350,000, sundry expenses, click on execute. See, no data read for the fiscal year 2016. Means in the year 2016, there is no transactional data in this GL account. Clear for everybody? I hope so. Now, see the next step. Display sample document. How to display sample document? These are all the end user transactions. Remember, these are all the end user requirements. Yes, I am sorry. There was a little bit of disturbance in the internet for a while. Now the internet resumed again. So let us log in again. I hope everybody hears me now. Okay. So display sample document. How to display sample documents? Transaction code FBM3. Click on document list button. Click on document list. Company code is 3699. Company code is 3699. Document number 1 to all 9s. because I don't know how many number of sample documents you have created. But if you know the number, you can directly enter the number. Fiscal year 2016. Fiscal year 2016. Click on execute. So in our class, we have created only one sample document. Then the system is displaying only one sample document. Then double click on the required document number. See, general expense account to cash. Like this, we can display any sample document. Now, see the step number 4. Posting of document by taking the sample document as a reference. Means, let us assume that just now you have incurred some sundry expenses. Some of the visitors came, so you have brought some snacks and cold drinks, etc., etc., for which you have incurred $10. Now, this transaction is to be posted into system. For that purpose, we can use the F-02 transaction code as usual, right? But let us see how to use the sample document to post this transaction. See, remember, when you create the sample document, it's not the rule that we have to use the sample document as a reference. Even though you have created the sample document for a business transaction, you can post the business transaction F-02 also in the normal way. But let us see how to use the sample document as a reference. Posting of document by taking sample document as a reference. Transaction code F-02. Same transaction code. Go to menu document, post with the reference. Go to menu document, post with the reference. Otherwise, you can go to the directly to the transaction code FBR2. Do one thing. Go to menu document, post with reference is there, no? Here you can write the transaction code FBR2. Sorry. Here. FBR2. Document number is equal to 1,01,000. Document number is equal to 1,01,000. Company code 3699. Fiscal year 2016. Select display line items. Select display line items. Click on enter. Look at the screen, everybody. Just now and today only, we have created the sample document. And today itself, we are using the sample document as a reference. That's why you need not change the document date and posting date. But if you use this sample document as a reference on any other day, we have to enter the document date and the posting date of the respective date. Right? That's why write down. Document date is 2/4/2016. Posting date is 2/4/2016. Look at the screen. You need not enter document type, period, company code, currency. Then you need not enter posting key. You need not enter account. It is enough if you change the document date and posting date in the document headers. Then click on enter. So amount is, let us say, $10. Amount is equal to $10. And you need not enter business area. You need not enter text. Again, you need not enter posting key for the credit line item. And you need not enter account number. So it is enough if you change the amount column for the first line item. Then enter. You have to change the amount for the second line item. Then you need not enter business area, you need not enter text. So just to change the amount column for both the line items, then click on save. Again, save. you have to click on enter, save two times. Sorry, you have to click on save two times. See, document 10 was posted in the company code 3699. Now your sundry expense account should have been updated. If you go to FS10N, $4,350,000 account number you enter. See, $10 is posted to the debit side. Clear, no? Like this, we can use the sample document any number of times as reference. Suppose, for example, again we have incurred $7 as sundry expenses. Again, we can use it. Go to, just look at the screen. It is not there in the material. F-02. Go to menu document, post with reference. Document number 1,01,000. Company code 3699. Fiscal year 2016. Select display line items. Click on enter. Click on enter. Amount is $7. Enter. Again, change the amount, $7. Click on save and save. See, document 11 was posted in the company code 3699. If you go to menu document display, this is the accounting document. General expense account are two, cash account. Document number 11, $7. Again, if you go to FS10N, display GL account balance, see, $17. If you double click on the total, you can display the line items. See, 10 and 7. Suppose again you have incurred $5, right? Again, you can use the sample document as reference. Document number 1,01,000. Select display line items. You need not change the amount also, because the amount of the actual business transaction is also same, $5. Enter. Save. Save. Document number 12 was posted. This is how the user, sorry, this is how the sample documents reduces the posting burden on the employees. I hope it is clear to everybody. See the next step. Change the sample document. FBM2. See, generally, right, in SAP, one, create. Number one, create. Number two, change. Number three, display. FBM3, display sample document. FBM2, change sample document. That's how we can remember the transaction codes. FBM2. Document number is equal to 1,01,000. Company code 3699. Fiscal year 2016. Click on enter. Double click on debit line item and credit line item and make the necessary changes. See? You can change the amount, you can change the value date, you can change the text. Right? So if you want to change anything, just double click on the line items, make the necessary changes and save. Okay. Then I told you we can delete the sample document. How? See the step number 6. Delete the sample document. Transaction code F.57. Company code is equal 3699. it's not possible to add one more line item in the existing sample document. Okay. Srinivas, you are Srinivas from Tanzania, right? Del, you are Mr. Srinivas from Tanzania, right?
Yes, sir. Yes. Okay. I'm Srinivas.
Yes. Okay. So we cannot add the line item in the existing document.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Yeah. Then,
so we have to create one more sample document in that case.
Exactly. The first document you can delete.
Okay.
That's what I'm going to show you now, how to delete the sample document. Transaction code F.57. Company code is equal to 3699. Document number is equal to 101. Fiscal year 2016. Select test run. Test run means trial run. Generally, when you are deleting anything from the database, first we execute it on trial run basis, right? So select test run. Click on execute. It says that two line items are there in this sample document. Just observe the sample document. Click on back arrow. Deselect test run. Then click on execute. Update run. Do you really want to delete? If you want to delete the document, click yes. This is how we can delete any sample document. So these are the functions relating to sample document. See the next topic. Recurring documents, right? So first I will explain the concept of recurring documents, right? Just to give me 1 minute. I am taking a little bit of breakfast. 1 second. 1 minute, please. Yes. See, recurring documents. So first I will explain what is the concept of the recurring documents. See, there are some business transactions which occur regularly at a fixed intervals. Interval may be a month, maybe 2 months, maybe 3 months, maybe 6 months, but that interval is fixed. Examples are rent payment, payment of term loan installment, and payment of vehicle loan, etc. Vehicle loan installment. In order to post this type of transactions, we can use the recurring document functionality. To use the recurring document functionality, two conditions are to be satisfied. Number one, the day of posting should be same in every interval, and the amount of the transaction should be same in every interval. See, for example, there are some business transactions which take place regularly in fixed intervals. This interval is always fixed. For example, you take rent. We have to pay rent on first of every month. So the rent payment is to be posted on first of every month. Here every month is called interval. And the day of posting is what? First of every month, right? So the day of posting is same every month. Then the amount of the business transaction is also same. Every month rent is same, right? So whenever any business transaction satisfies these two conditions, we can use the recurring document functionality to post. Similarly, take vehicle loan installment. Let us assume we have taken one vehicle loan and it has to be repaid. The vehicle loan is to be repaid in the form of installments on 5th of every month. 5th is the interval. Day of posting is, see, I am not saying posting date, day of posting, posting day, 5th of every month, right? So the day of posting is same in every month, in every interval. Similarly, the amount of vehicle loan installment is also same every month. Then we can use this recurring document functionality. Similarly, we have taken 4-5 term loans. Let us assume we have to repay the installments of all these 4-5 term loans on first of every month. So the day of posting is same. And the amount of the term loan installment is also same. So like that, for any business transaction which satisfies these two conditions, we can use the recurring document functionality. Suppose, let us assume that we are paying the salaries on 28th of every month. So day of posting is same. But the amount of the salary, total salary bill, will not be same every month. The total amount of salaries may be changing from month to month. In that case, we cannot use the recurring document functionality. We can use sample document if you want. I hope it is clear to everybody. So like that, there are some business transactions which occur regularly at fixed intervals and the amount of the transactions also same. Then, in order to post those transactions, we use the recurring document functionality. For example, let us assume that there are 500 business transactions which are taking place on first of every month. Okay, then we create 500 recurring documents for these 500 business transactions. Then they are just stored in the database. When you create the recurring document, they do not update any GL accounts. Then on the first of every month, the user executes one transaction code. In that transaction code, the user enters the information in only 7 to 8 fields. Then the system will post all 500 accounting documents on first of every month. In order to post 500 accounting documents, we need not use the F-02 transaction code 500 times. We use a separate transaction code wherein the user enters the information in 7 to 8 fields. Then the system will post all 500 documents on the first of every month. Posting burden is reduced, you know. That is the concept of the recurring documents. So when you create the recurring documents also, the system will not update any GL accounts. When we post the actual business transactions, by executing the recurring cycle, then only the account balances of the respective GL accounts will be updated. And also, we have to define a separate number range for recurring documents also. The number range number is X1. Okay? And the following functions are available for the recurring documents. Number one, display. As in the case of sample documents, we can display the recurring documents. We can change the recurring documents and we can delete the recurring documents. So this is the function of the recurring documents. Let us see how to configure. And one more thing is, at the time of creating the recurring document, for every recurring document, we have to specify first run date, last run date, and interval for posting. This I will explain while creating the recurring documents. So before configuration, let's have a break of 10 minutes. Yes, I am back. Srinivas, are you there? Kalyan, are you there? Kalyan. Okay, Srinivas. Kirti. Okay. Sailaja. Sailaja. Srinivas, Srinivas Yelamanchi. Okay, Kalyan. Okay, Srinivas Yelamanchi. Tahir, are you there? Tahir. Tejasvi, are you there? Tejasvi. Giri.
Yes, sir, I'm here.
Okay. Okay, Tahir. Okay, Giri. See the first step in the material. Creation of number ranges for recurring documents. FBN1. Same transaction code. Company code is 3699. Anybody has opened the same screen? Anybody has opened the same screen? Kalyan, can you please close the screen? Kalyan, you have opened the same screen, FBN1. Please close your screen.
Oh, okay, sorry, clear.
Yeah.
Yeah, I closed it, sir.
Yes, now we got it. See, previously Kalyan has opened the same screen. That's why we could not get this change in rules button highlighted. So company code is equal to 3699. And please don't do the practice simultaneously with me, right? After the class, you can do the practice. Because you cannot concentrate on the explanation and practice. Company code is 3699. Click on change intervals. Click on insert intervals. Number is equal to X1. Number is equal to X1. Year is 2016. From number 201. Because 1 to 1 lakh, SA type. 1 lakh 1 to 2 lakhs, X2. Now 2 lakh 1 to 3 lakhs. From number is equal to 2 lakh 1. To number 3 lakhs. 1 second. Yes, I am back. From number is equal to 2,01,000. To number is 3 lakhs. Click on save. And enter. Now see the next step. Creation of recurring document. See, out of the GL accounts you have created, right? Rent business transaction or the rent GL account satisfies these two conditions. So let us create the recurring document for the rent account. Creation of recurring document, transaction code FBD1. Company code is equal to 3699. Company code is equal to 3699. First run on 1/1/2016. Generally, these recurring documents are created as to be posted from the beginning of the years. Last run on 31/12/1999. Means throughout the life of the enterprise, throughout the life of the client company, we want to use this recurring document as template. Suppose, for example, if the rent agreement is only for 5 years, right? In that case, we can directly enter 31/12/2020. So based on the duration for which you want to use this recurring document as template, that much duration we have to enter. Just like that, I'm using last run on 31/12/1999. Then interval in months. Interval in months. How frequently you want to post it? If you press on F4, you can see the options. If you have to post this document, or if you have to post this business transaction every month, we enter 01. If you have to post this transaction every 2 months, we enter 02. If you have to post this transaction every quarter or every 3 months, we enter 03. Because this is the rent business transaction, every month you have to pay rent and you have to post, right? That's why we have to select 01. Suppose we have taken one term loan. So how frequently the term loan installment is to be repaid? How do we decide? We cannot decide on our own. The repayment schedule is contained in the loan agreement. At the time of taking any loan, we have to sign the agreement. And that agreement clearly specifies, agreement means agreement with the bank. So that loan agreement with the bank will clearly specify what is the repayment schedule. If the installment is to be repaid every month, we enter 01. If the installment is to be repaid every 2 months, we enter 02. If it is a quarterly repayment, we enter 03. Clear? So based on the nature of the business transaction, we have to decide the interval in posting. Okay? So interval in months, 01. Document type, SCA. Document type, SCA. Other things are as usual. Posting key 40. I am creating the recurring document for rent business transaction. Posting key 40. Account is 4,300,000 rent account. Account is 4,300,000. Click on enter. It is giving a warning message. First run is in the past. Actually, we are in April, but we have given the first run on 1/1/2016. That is why it is giving the warning message. Just ignore the warning message. Amount is equal to 10,000. Business area 3699. Business area 3699. text being rent paid. Text being rent paid. Posting key 50. Posting key 50. Account is 2,100,000. Click on enter. Amount is asterisk. Business area 3699. Text plus. Business area 3699. Text plus. Click on save. See, document 2,01,000 was stored in the company code 3699. Because this is the number range we have defined just now for X1. X1 is for recurring documents. So like that, we create the recurring documents for all the business transactions which satisfies these two conditions. Okay. Now, in our example also, let us assume you have created 100 recurring documents for 100 business transactions which are to be posted on 1st of every month. Then only you can understand the use of this recurring document functionality at the end of the topic. See the next step. To display recurring document, F.15. Company code is equal to 3699. Company code is equal to 3699. Document number 1 to all 9s, because I don't know how many number of recurring documents we have created. Document number is equal to 1 to all 9s. Fiscal year 2016. Fiscal year 2016. Click on execute. Here we have created only one recurring document. The system is displaying that recurring document only. So how to interpret this? Look at the screen, everybody, please. Company code 3699. Item number means line item number. Line. One second. Line item number 1. Line item number 2. Similarly, document number 2,01,000. PK means posting key. Posting key 40 for the first line item, 50 for the second line item. Then account type, both the line items are GL account types. Then posting date 2/4/2016 means this is the day on which you have created this recurring document. Then first run 1/1/2016, next run 1/1/2016. I told you, every month the user has to execute the recurring cycle. The user has to run the recurring cycle. In the original recurring document, you specified that the first run is to be carried from 1/1/2016. But did you execute the recurring cycle run? No. That's why system is saying that next run 1/1/2016. Last run 31st December 1999. And first line item number 4,300,000. Second line item GL account number 2,100,000. And this is the amount. This is how we have to interpret the recurring document. Okay. See here, in the recurring document, right? In the original recurring document, we have specified the first run on 1/1/2016, right? So every month first, the user has to execute the recurring cycle. Means the user has to run recurring cycle, then only the documents are posted. Did you run the cycle on 1st January 2016 till now? Giri? No. That's why it is saying that next run on 1/1/2016. Clear now? Clear, Giri? Okay. So, see the next step. to post the documents using recurring document. I told you, every month first, right, the user has to execute one transaction code. That is called executing recurring cycle. Transaction code F.14. See, create posting documents from recurring documents. Company code is equal to 3699. Company code is equal to 3699. Document number 1 to all 9s. Because I don't know the document numbers, because I told you to assume that we have created 100 recurring documents to be posted on first of every month. So we can enter 1 to all 9s. Fiscal year 2016. Fiscal year 2016. Then settlement period is equal to 1-1-2016. Settlement period is equal to 1-1-2016. Within brackets. It is the date. It is the date on which the recurring documents are to be posted. Sorry, on which the accounting documents are to be posted. It is the date on which the accounting documents are to be posted. Using recurring cycle. Using recurring cycle. That is the meaning of the settlement period, nothing else. Batch input session name is equal to boss 1 to 3. Batch input session is equal to boss 1 to 3. So what is the batch input session? Right? In the material itself, please write down. Batch input session, sorry, not batch input session, batch input. Batch input is the group of similar items. Batch input is the group of similar items for a processing purpose. The batch inputs are used to process the large volumes of data. To process the large volumes of data. Means here, batch input is the group of similar items. What are the similar items here? Look at the screen. Here we have given the document number 1 to all 9s, right? So between these two numbers, the system will identify only those documents which are to be posted on this day, 1-1-2016. The similarity is to be posted on 1-1-2016. This is the similarity. So based on the similarity, the system will group all these 100 documents together. I told you, to assume that we have created 100 recurring documents for 100 business transactions. So the system will create one object which encompasses all these 100 documents. This object is called batch input. Okay. So for that batch input, we have given one name. Just like that, I have given boss 1, 2, 3. We can give any name. Okay? Then click on execute. See the message on the status bar. Session boss 1, 2, 3 was created. Remember, only the batch input session was created. The accounting documents are not yet posted. When you execute the batch input session, then only the system will post 100 accounting documents. Because I told you to assume that we have 100 recurring documents created, right? So when you execute the batch input session boss 1, 2, 3, then only the system will post 100 accounting documents. So to post 100 accounting documents, the user is just entering the information in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. That's it. Then how to execute the batch input session? See the material, step number 5. To post the document by executing batch input session, go to menu, system, services, batch input sessions. Go to menu, system, services, batch input sessions. Otherwise, you can use the transaction code SM35. Generally, these batch inputs are executed by basis system end users, right? Generally, what happens is these batch inputs are executed during the night times. Here, in our example, this batch input contains 100 documents to be processed, right? So it will take little bit of time. It will take little bit more time. If you execute these batch inputs during the day times, what happens? The load on the servers are very high. Because every user is using the servers to perform their daily work, right? That's why during the daytime, the load on the servers are very much high. Okay, that's why generally these batch inputs are executed during the night times. In the night times, only technical departments or the manufacturing departments are working. The other departments will not work. So obviously, the load on the servers is a little bit low. Then if you execute this batch input sessions, the processing is completed very fast. So by the time tomorrow morning, when the user comes to his office, 100 entries will be posted. Clear, no? So how to execute batch input? Go to the transaction code SM35 or the path. Select the session boss 1, 2, 3. Select the session boss 1, 2, 3. Click on execute process. Select display errors only. Click on process. See, selecting display errors only means during the processing, right, if the system finds any errors, it will maintain the log. Nothing else. Look at the screen. Processing of batch input session completed. Click on exit batch input. Now the business transaction should have been posted. In our batch input session, we have only one recurring document. But if you have 100 recurring documents, system will post 100 accounting entries. Clear now how this is reducing the posting button? See the next step. To display the document posted by the recurring cycle, go to the transaction code FB03. If you go to FB03, the system will take the latest document posted, right? Automatically. So document number is called 13. Company code 3699. Fiscal year 2016. Click on enter. See, rent account data to cash, 10,000. You see the document date and posting date, 1-1-2016. So, this entry was posted on 1-1-2016. Any doubts from anybody in this regard? Now, see the next step in the material. Change the recurring document, right? So before changing the recurring document, I will tell you some other topics. See, we have executed the recurring cycle on 1st January 2016, right? Now, let us display the original recurring document. F.15. Just look at the screen. Company code 3699. Document number 201. Fiscal year 2016. Click on execute. See, next run was automatically changed to because you have executed the recurring cycle, settlement period you have given 1-1-2016. That's why the document was posted on 1-1-2016. Because that is the date on which the document is to be posted every month. First of every month, right?
Okay, sir. Okay, understood.
Now, you have executed the recurring cycle on 1st January 2016. Now, yes, again, we have to execute for the month of February. See, the look at the screen. That's what I'm showing you now. See, next run is automatically updated to 1st February 2016. So based on the frequency you have given in the original recurring document, once you execute the recurring cycle, system automatically updates the next run date. That's how user can understand. When you display the recurring document, user can understand easily, okay, we have to execute this recurring cycle next month first. I mean, 1st February. Clear? Now, let us execute the recurring cycle for the month of February. Same procedure, just look at the screen. F.40. Company code is 3699. Document number 12R9. Fiscal year 2016. Settlement period 1st February 2016. Batch input session, hi. Give any name. Click on execute. See, session hi was created. Now again, we have to execute the batch input session. You can go to the path. Otherwise, you can use the transaction code SM35. Select the session hi. Click on execute process. Select display errors only, click on process, click on exit batch input. If you go to FB03, document number 14, see, rent account data to cash, posting date and document date is 1st February 2016. Let us display again the original recurring document, F.15. See, next run is automatically updated to 1st March 2016. Now, let us execute again for the 1st March. Just look at the screen. Company code 3699. Document number 12R9. Fiscal year 2016. Now, when do you have to execute the recurring cycle again according to schedule? When do you have to execute the recurring cycle again? 1st March, right? But here, what I am doing is, let us assume I have forgotten to execute the recurring cycle on 1st March. Now, 1st April came. Now, I am executing for 1st April 2016. See, I have skipped the execution of recurring cycle for the 1st March, right? Now I am executing the recurring cycle for 1st April. Let us see what happens. Click on execute. See the message. See the message on the status bar. Session boss 123 was not created. Means without executing the recurring cycle for the previous month, system will not allow the user to execute for the current month. That's how system automatically takes control to see that every month is recurring cycle is executed, every month rent is posted. Here we are having only one transaction. That's why it is posting only one document. If you have created 100 recurring documents, every month the system will post 100 entries on 1st of every month. That is another advantage of this recurring document. System automatically takes control to see that every month documents are posted. So when you change the date, see, session boss 123 was created. So go to menu, system, services, batch input, sessions. Select the session boss 123. Click on execute process. Select display errors. Click on process. Click on exit batch input. Now, if you go to FB03, rent account data to cash, document date and posting date, 1st March 2016. So, if you go to F.15, display original recurring document. See, next run is automatically updated to 1/4/2016. Clear, no? The concept and the configuration. Now, change the recurring document. Why? Why we have to change the recurring document? I will give one business scenario. Our rent agreement has lapsed by February 2016. So from March onwards, there is an increment in the rent 10%. The rent is to be increased by 10% from the month of March according to lease agreement. And the March rent we are paying on 1st April, right? So from 1st April onwards, the rent business transaction is to be posted with the increased amount. For that purpose, we need to change the recurring document. Procedure is transaction code FBD2. Document number is equal to 2,01,000. Document number is equal to 2,01,000. Company code 3699. Company code 3699. Fiscal year 2016. Click on enter. Double click on the debit line item and credit line item. Make the necessary changes. Here I want to change the amount. Okay. Double click on rent account. 20% increase means 2,000 and 10,000, right? So 12,000. Click on back arrow. You have to change the amount for credit line item also. The amount is equal to 12,000. Click on save. Now from now onwards, when you execute the recurring cycle from 1st April, the system will post this transaction with 12,000 amount. Just look at the screen. I am executing the recurring cycle for the month of April again. F.14. Document number 1 to all names. Fiscal year 2016. Settlement period 1/4/2016. Batch input session name hello. Click on execute. Session hello was created. Go to the transaction code SM35. Select the session hello. Click on execute process. Select display errors. Click on process. Click on exit batch input. Go to FB03. See, rent account data to cash 12,000. And the document date and posting date is 1/4/2016. This is how we can change the recurring document. Okay. Now, see the next step. Delete recurring document, right? Here on the top of the page, you have some space, right? Otherwise, to the left side of your page, you have some space. Please write down there. In order to delete the recurring document, we have to select the deletion indicator. We have to select the deletion indicator the deletion indicator in the original recurring document in the original recurring document in the original recurring document procedure. Got the point? If you want to delete the recurring document, there is one indicator, deletion indicator, in the original document. So first you have to select that indicator. Otherwise, it's not possible to delete the recurring document. Procedure. Go to the transaction code FBD2. FBD2 means change recurring document, right? Document number is equal to 201. Company code 3699. Fiscal year 2016. You have to write. Go to menu view. Recurring entry data. Select deletion indicator. Click on save. Look at the other information of the screen. Here, number of runs, 4. Means till now we have completed 4 runs. Okay? Then, this is the information provided. And again, interval in months, 1. Here, I will tell you one business scenario. Originally, okay, we have taken one term loan, right? According to original loan agreement, we have to repay the installment every month. That's why at the time of creating the recurring document, we have given the interval in months 1. So after 2-3 years, right, the bank has been very much satisfied with our repayments. So we have requested them to extend the interval. Then the bank has agreed, and instead of every month, they have given the permission to us to pay the term loan installment every 3 months. Are you getting my point? In that case, we have to change the interval in months. That is also quite possible in this transaction code. Clear? So here we have selected deletion indicator. Now we can delete the recurring document. Click on save. See the last step. Delete a recurring document, F.56. company code is equal to 3699. Document number 201. Fiscal year 2016. Fiscal year 2016. Select a test run. Click on execute. Observe the document. Click on back arrow. Deselect test run. Click on execute. Update run. Do you really want to delete? Yes. Click yes on the message. Okay. Now, I will tell you some other functions relating to recurring documents. In app.14, execute a recurring document cycle. Settlement period, we have range, right? From date and to date. So how can we use this date range, right? For example, we have some 25 recurring documents to be executed on 1st. We have another 50 recurring documents to be executed on 2nd of every month. We have another 100 documents to be executed on 5th of every month. So in April, we did not execute on 1st and 2nd. Today is 5th, let us assume, right? Then today we are executing the recurring cycle. In that case, actually we did not post the documents on 1st and 2nd of April, right? In that case, you can enter the date range. 1/4/2016 to 5/4/2016. Then the system will execute all the recurring documents on specified dates between these two dates. Clear? That's how we can use the settlement period here. Then what is the run schedule? What is the run schedule? Here, I hope this point is clear. What is the use of the settlement period date range? Then I'm going to explain you run schedule now. FBD1. See, in the FBD1, we are creating the recurring documents, right? So minimum interval is 1 month. Okay. But there are some business transactions which are to be posted. For example, there are some business transactions which are to be posted on 1st, 5th, 10th, 15th, 20th, 25th of every month. Every month. We have to post that some transactions on 5th, 10th, 15th, 20th and 25th. In that case, what we do is, we define our run schedule. In the run schedule, you specify all the dates on which you want to post. Right? Means, on the irregular dates of every interval, see, if you have to post some transactions every month, but the dates are different. In that case, we can use this run schedules, right? Put heading in the notes. Recurring documents run schedules. Recurring documents run schedules. The run schedules are used The run schedules are used to post the recurring documents on uneven dates in every interval. In every interval. For this, we define the run schedule. We define the run schedule with the required dates. We define the run schedule with the required dates. And the run schedule is assigned in the original recurring document. Steps. Define run schedule. Path is SPRO. Financial accounting. I will tell you transaction code, right? First write the path, I will tell you the transaction code also. SPRO, Financial Accounting Global Settings. Financial Accounting Global Settings. Document. Recurring entries. Define run schedules. Transaction code OBC1. Transaction code OBC1. Click on new entries. Run schedule is equal to 3699. Run schedule is equal to 3699. Description is equal to 5th, 10th, 15th of every month. 5th, 10th, 15th of every month. Click on save. Step number 2. Enter run dates. Path is same as above. Enter run dates. Path same as above. Transaction code OBC2. Transaction code OBC2. Run schedule is equal to 3699. run schedule is equal to 3699. Click on enter. Click on enter. Click on new entries. Click on new entries. Enter the run dates. Enter the run dates. So here I have to post 5th, 10th, 15th of every month, right? So I have to enter all the dates. 5-1-2016, then 10-1-2016, then 15-1-2016, then 5-2-2016. Yes, Giri. Giri, any problem? Sailaja, can you hear me? Because Giri says that he is not able to hear me. Okay, Tahir. Okay. Enter the run dates, right? So 10-2-2016, similarly 15-2-2016, like that every month we have to enter the dates. Click on save. Step number 3. Assign the run schedule. In the original recurring document, assign the run schedule in the original recurring document in the transaction code FBD1. In the transaction code FBD1. See, in the transaction code FBD1, we create the recurring cycle, no? So here you can assign the run schedule. Then according to the dates in the run schedule, the system will post the transactions when you execute the recurring cycle in UP.14. Right? So remaining things we will see tomorrow. Srinivas from Tanzania. Can you hear? Do you have any questions? There are two persons in the class with the same name Srinivas. That's why I'm specifying like this. Okay. Kalyan. Okay. Kirti. Kirti. See, Kirti, I have to send you the certificate, right? Actually, what happened is, there is a problem in my system. I don't know what is that problem. I am not able to create your PDF, right? Kirti, are you there? Kirti. Okay. Sailaja, you have any questions? Sailaja, you have any questions?
No, sir. Can you hear?
Okay. Srinivas Yalamanchi, any questions? Okay. Tahir? Okay. Tejasvi? Okay. Giri? It seems that Giri is not able to hear me. Okay then. See you tomorrow same time. Good night and good day. And you can use the same link every day. Thank you, Tahir.